Thank you. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, hope you don't mind if I say a few words in English. I'm sorry, I don't know your beautiful but difficult language. It's not my native tongue. My mother tongue is French. I think I speak for all of us here on the stage. You say we're so happy to play in this hall, not because it's a beautiful hall, but because it has the name Arbopert, and it's one of our favorite composers. It's what he created is pure magic, and I think the whole cultural center here and the whole space is a reflection of his magic. It's going through the woods when we come here, and it's like it comes out of nature, it comes out of the woods, it's hidden in the forest. It's exactly like his music would come, it makes the soul rise. So we are very happy and humbled to be in a place that is in the... that was built for the posterity, and I hope he's with us many, many more years, but he'll be here forever. And it's a way, it's like a church, or it's like a place of worship, that we can worship his music and all music. Another favorite composer of mine and of ours is Astor Piazzolla. I had the opportunity to meet him in 1984. I played for him The History of Tango. And it's always the question, is it classical music or is it not? Some people ask the same question for Arvo Pärt and Philip Glass and some of the new age music. What is classical music? Where does it stop? Where does it start? I think we all agree that there's only good music and bad music, whatever it is. And you can have genius music from Simon and Garfunkel, or you can have very bad good music from classical composer. So, of course, the Four Seasons of Buenos Aires, we will play two seasons for you now. It's not really the seasons like Vivaldi, descriptive music. It's the Four Seasons of Buenos Aires, not of nature, really. Buenos Aires is a very noisy city. I don't know if you've been there. And some of the tango reflects this activity, this emotion, this deep, deep sense of anxiety in a way. So, you know, by now, I saw the picture of Gidon Kremer, who came to play here, I'm sure, and he was a champion of tango also. He took the tango from the cabaret, from the dancing halls, into the concert stage. Actually, his piece, The History of Tango, has four movements. 1900, brothel. 1930, café. 1960, nightclub. 1980, concert. So that's the history of tango, and it's not finished. Tango is like classic, like jazz, or like other style of music, a whole world of music, and you have the traditional, you have the modern, the postmodern, and you have all kinds of, like jazz. So he was a great genius, and we're happy to play his music for you. Thank you. another composer who borrowed a lot from popular music was Fritz Kreisler, the great violinist from Vienna. And in many of his pieces, like Gustav Mahler and a lot of Viennese composers, you find the Ländler, the little songs, and the little folklore from Vienna, which is very specific. So here's Little Miniature March by Fritz Kreisler. Thank you.
I would like to say that on behalf of the Heidelberg Center, we're so honored and thankful for the opportunity of having such wonderful wonderful artists here in our hall, in our small hall, and to listen to your beautiful playing and the special pieces you have chosen for us. And thank you for the audience, aitäh kallis publik, et te tulite. And there is somebody who has a big role in the fact that you are here and in the fact that Odessa Classics is taking place in Estonia this year, despite the terrible situation, but still the festival tradition is not stopping. Nii et ma annaksin sõna üle. Thank you, Meelis Kubits.
Eesti keeles, et kui tänamiseks läks, et Odessa Classics 2015. aastal sündis väga erakorralistes oludes ja ainult erainitsiatiivi, et ei olnud tol hetkel riigil väga palju mahti, kas selles muusikaga tegeleda. Ja see, mida Aleksei ja Lena Odessas korda saatnud, on imeline. Ja nii nagu ka meie sõsarfestival või pagulusfestival, nii nagu teda oleme Eesti äärimuses nimetanud Odessa Classics Tallinn, sündis loetud tundide jooksul lihavate pühade ajal ja siis ei siis mõned nädalad ja kuu poolteist tegeleda müügiga. Ja kui sa teed midagi erainitsiatiivi ja tahad teha suveräänselt ja tahad olla selle juures vaba, siis kogu asja nagu võti on toetajad. Ja igaüks, kes teist täna tuli siia saali, kas ostis pileti või valas bensiinipaaki bensiini, on võinud kulutusi selle festivali toimumise jaoks ja neil on olnud tegelikult väga suur ja väga laiapõhjaline toetajatest koosnev tiim ja ei saa öelda, et riik üldse midagi ole teinud, et esiteks on Eesti riiklik sümfoonia orkester on riiklik ja teiseks on Eesti Rahvusringhääling kannab meie eufoorilise avakontserdi üle homme õhtul Eesti Televisiooni teises programmis ja pühapäeval siis põhiprogrammis, nii et see on väga oluline ja seal on ka võimalik koguda annetusi Odessa vanima ajalehe õhtune Odessa toetuseks ja kuulivestide ostmiseks Odessa sõjaväeorkestrile. Aga ma tahaks selle liige kimpu anda üle toetajatele. Siin saalis on mõned inimesed, kes on festivaliga rahaliselt olulisel määral toetanud ja siin on saalis on ka üks inimene, kes 2015. aastal, kui me käisime Odessas, pani üle alla on Mart Habakuk, kes on ka siin saalis ja inimene, kelle pool ma pöördusin esimese kõnega festivali toetajate otsimise kaasamise osas on Siiri Tamm. Ma Siiri väga palun, et äkki sa tuled lavale ja siis toetajate nimel annan sulle väikse kinnituse.